David Brehart has emailed in to ask us how to speed paint Iron Warriors Chaos Space Marines. So today we're going to show you a fantastic method of doing this that gives a really dark and gritty colour scheme, which is perfect for these Sons of Perturabo. Now, to do this colour scheme, what you need to do is start out from an undercoat of Lead Belcher spray, which you can see is what I've done for my example model just here. And the colours you're going to need are Null Oil, followed by Avalan Sunset. You're also going to need Seraphim Sepia and Reichlin Flesh Shade. Now, after that, you'll need Abaddon Black, Evilson Scarlet, and also Rakarth Flesh as well. But we're going to be starting out with Null Oil, which I'm going to be applying using a medium shade brush. And as always, you want to use your palette here to help control exactly how much paint you're applying at once. So get a good little dollop on the palette like this, then load up your brush, and all you've got to do is start applying this all over your miniature. So you want to make sure it settles nicely in all the recessed detail, and then you get it into all those nooks and crannies. So don't be afraid to be generous as you apply this. Once that shade is completely dry, you're then ready to pick any panels that you want to have chevrons on later on and base coat them using Avalan Sunset using a medium base brush. And for my example, I'm going to go for this shoulder pad here. Once you've finished blocking out those sections with Avalan Sunset, you're then ready to return to Null Oil to apply a second coat of it all over the armour once more, a little bit thinner than before. Once that shade is completely dry, we can now move on to painting the trim. And for this, we're going to start out with Seraphim Sepia applied using a medium layer brush. And what you want to do is just paint this onto the panels all the way around like this so the colour starts to stain that trim. Now, I want the colour to be a little bit stronger, so once this first coat is dry, apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way. And once you finish those two coats of Seraphim Sepia, then repeat them with a single coat of Reichlin Flesh Shade, again applied using a medium layer brush. And with that shade also dry, we can now move on to base coating all the details that require Abaddon Black. And there's a few details to do here. First of all, we need to paint the casing on the bolt gun, but also you need to look out for the joints in the armour, any fabric, any pipes, and of course the chevrons as well. And for these, just start in the middle with a straight line around about here for the shoulder pad, and then use this as a guideline to start working out on either side. We now just have a few small details left to do, and first of all we need to paint in the eyes using Evilson Scarlet. And for this we recommend using a small airbrush and just being as neat as you can as you paint the raised area of the lens. And finally, use Rakarth Flesh to pick out any bone details, for example this small claw that we've got down here. And with that, this Iron Warrior is now ready to be based. Now, for a really dark colour scheme like this, we do recommend you go for a lighter basing colour. For example, a Grelum Badland is an excellent choice for a model like this. But David, I really hope this helps you out when you're painting your Iron Warrior's army, and we'll see you all again soon.